FX Avatar, coming to you once again from Simville on Pandora's Planet. EA just presented us with a great update, the Living Large update, where our plot sizes of our land are now 18 by 36. Today we're going to design a home on one of those larger plots of land for a widowed mom, her child, and two roommates. First thing we're going to do is save your game to the cloud. That is the first thing you should always do when you're trying something new, just in case you change your mind and want to go back to what was before. So, while you're saving your game to the cloud, I'll show you what we're going to be building on today. As I mentioned, this is going to be a home for a widowed mom, her child, and two tenants. This property was originally designed for a family of four, but with the loss of her husband, remodeling was done to allow for tenants. So today, this is the home we are going to build. Since the plots of land are much bigger than they were previously, we will do our best to show it here. As you can see, this is the front of the property here. Let's do it this way. This is the front of the property. We're going to go one in from the 1 through 18, as we mentioned, which is still the same as before. I think we're going to need to make this a little bit heavier so you can actually see the drawings properly. Let's try this. Yes, that's much better. So we've gone in one from the bottom. And the main room is going to be here. This is the mother's room here, and the numbers are as follows. So it's one in from the bottom, and it's three in from the side, because this is actually a bathroom that goes with this room here. So it's three in for the bathroom, and then on the fourth one, you're going to start with the mom's master room. So it's going to be 11 across, and it's going to be seven up. So that is one room. And then we're going to have the child's room, which is going to be off the mom's room. And that's going to be four across and seven up. So those are your rooms so far, the master room and the child's room. Then you're going to have the bathroom for one of the tenants. So the bathroom is next to the master room, and it is three across and seven up. And then it opens up into the bedroom here. So this is bedroom number one. And that's going to be six across and six up. From that bedroom, we're going to go to the next bedroom, and that's also going to be six across, and this one is going to be seven up, because this doesn't have an external bathroom from the bedroom. It's going to be part of this bedroom. And let's come back down here towards the master room, master bedroom. We're going to have a living room area here. The living room area is going to be a communal living room area, and that's going to be seven across and seven up. Across in the communal living room will be the game room. We have a game room here. At some point in time when the child is big enough, we might consider moving the child up and rearranging this area a bit. But for right now, since it's a toddler, it can stay close to its mom. Off of the game room, we have a bathroom, a very small bathroom. It's going to be three across and three up, the nine squares, which are the minimum amount of squares to use in order to build anything in Simville. Next to the bathroom is going to be the entryway. So you're actually going to come in through this door to enter into the property. And the entryway is very simple. It's just going to be four across and four up and down. Right off the entryway, we're going to have a kitchen. This kitchen area is going to be six across and seven up and down. Next to the kitchen, or off the kitchen area, we're going to have the patio area, the barbecue grill. We're going to make space for a dog here. And then right off that, we're going to start building our hot tub. Not really a hot tub, but for our purposes, we're going to call it a hot tub. And we're going to build four across and three up and down. We're going to come have a tiki bar on this side here. And then we are going to build a rather large pool at the back area. So you have a center island here where you can do some mats or the slide, whatever you decide to do. So this would be a center area with the pool directly around it. So again, this is what we're going to build. So we go back towards the front so you can see it again. And of course, all of these will be detailed in the show mode tab below. with all the numbers included. You will even do a picture of this particular drawing so you can have it for reference. Okay, let's start building. Let's get to the fun part. And we're going to go over to our property that we are going to be building on. Since I'm going to be building from scratch, I chose to get an empty lot to start. Here we go. So this is our empty lot. We're going to view the house. So this is our empty lot here. So first thing we're going to do is going to go into the umbrella and the chair to get our build mode. So we're going to go into rooms, and this gives us our squares here so we can begin to build. As you mentioned, on the left hand side, we're going to go 3 across and 7 up, and that is going to be for the bedroom of the bathroom for one of the tenants. So we're going to go 3 across, 3, and we're going to go 7 up. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Of course, you want to double check your numbers because we do not like to waste simoleons. It's rather expensive these days. Let's count. Come down 1. And I believe that gives us our 7 and 3. Let's double check. Actually, we're over too much. We're going to have to delete that and try it again. I'm going to go 3 across and 7 up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Double check our numbers. That looks about right. 1, 2, 3, and then we're going to go 7 up. So that is our first bathroom we're building. Next, we're going to build the master bedroom. It's going to be 11 across and 7 up. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 7 up. Let's double check our numbers. Beautiful, and 7 up, because we know this was 7. We're gonna hit the green check mark. Next, we're going to build a child's room, and the child's room is going to be the remainder of the squares and 7 up. So that gives you the child's room, which is going to be 3 up. We missed the fourth one, so let's go one more. So it's going to be 4 across and the 7 up. There we go, 4 across, and we know this is 7, so it's equal out to 7. So there we go, have the child's room. Next, we're going to build a game room right off the child's room, and that is going to be 5 across and 3 up. So we start from this edge here. And we're going to go 5 across, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 across, and 3 up, 1, 2, 3. As you meant from previous videos, we always count this last square twice. So if we go 5 across, we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 3 up, this square gets counted twice, and this is 1, 2, 3 up. So we have our game room, 5 and 3. Next, we are going to build our bathroom off the game room. And we're going to go in about 2 squares, which to guess it'll give a little area just so it's not all blocks on this side. So we go in 2 first, and then we'll start here. And we're going to go 3 across and 3 up. That gives us the 9 squares, the minimum you can build or use to build anything on Simville. So we've got our 3 and 3. Hit a green mark. We're next going to build our entryway, which is going to be 4 across and 4 up. We're going to come here, 1 on the outside, and go 1, 2, 3, 4. And we're going to go 4 up. 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to double check your numbers again, and that looks about right. So that is our entryway. Now we're going to build our kitchen. It's going to be right above the entryway. It's going to be 6 across and 7 up and down. So let's start at the edge. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's check our numbers before we hit the green check mark. 6 and 7, green check mark, and that is our kitchen area complete. We're going to go over and we're going to build our living room area, which is going to be in the center here. The living room area is going to be 7 across and 7 up off the game room. So we start in the corner by the game room, in the corner here, and we're going to go 7 across, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 7 up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Again, do you want to check our numbers? Beautiful, 7 and 7. That is our living room area. And now we are going to build our first bedroom, which is going to be utilizing this bathroom area here. And that is going to be the remainder of this space and 6 up. So we can start from the edge here since we're using all this space. And we're going to go 6 up. Let's check our numbers. Remainder of the space and 6 up. Beautiful. Then we're going to build our second bedroom. It's going to be 6 across and 7 up. So we can start here and 7 up. 1, 2, 3, 7. Check your numbers again. Beautiful. So we've just done our two bedrooms. We've done the living room area. And we have done the child's room, the game area, the master, or I should say the main bathroom right off the entryway, right off the kitchen area. Let's go towards the back now where you can actually see the waves lapping against the shoreline. Very cool. I'm waiting for the next update where we can actually walk on the beach and or put lounge chairs on the beach and just sit on the beach. Maybe even swim on the beach. It'd be kind of cool. I'm going to build our pool area. So we're going to go out of here and we're going to look for pools. And that is our pool area right there. We're in our pool section. We're going to go the second one in from the top and the second one in from the left. So we're going to start here. We're going to go across. Leave one on each side and we're going to go 3 down. So we should have our area, so it's 3 and all the way across the entire length of the pool. And you've got your decorative tiles around your pool. So that is our first pool. So now we're going to build our next section of the pool. We're actually going to start from the top. We're going to go here and we're going to go 1 in from this side. And we're going to go across and we're going to go up. And we're going to connect the pools. Again, you have to make sure that it goes over to yellow. Once it's yellow, you know you've got enough. And that's going to be 4 across. Let's do 3 across. 3 across, and we've counted the ones up. So it connects 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it's 3 across and 7 up. And now we're going to do our third part. We will start it here. It's going to be 2 in from the kitchen we just built and 1 in from the edge, and we're going to go up and over 3. Make sure again that it is yellow so that you know you can actually build there. That is perfect. You can always extend it. So now we're going to do our final part to do connectors. We'll start here to up, go across, get it onto the yellow, and then we're going to extend it over as far over as it can go. Well, I think we're going to have to make it a little bit smaller because it's having issues with the building there. So we're going to make it smaller here. And then we're going to connect it over this way. Oops, still having issues with the kitchen. Make it a little bit smaller again. Or actually what we can do, we're going to make the kitchen one length smaller. You bring the kitchen down 1 to give us space to bring the pool all the way across. We go back into our pool areas. Let's see if we can get this finished. There we go. Okay, so that is how we're going to do our pool. And I've noticed something really cool. You can actually maneuver a little bit and bring some of the arrows in to get some definition on your pool. So I want to put some lounge chairs here so that the folks can use this area to look over and watch the waves come in. So I'm going to pull this in about right there. And I'll pull this in, just one in. See if it works. I don't think this one doesn't have enough space to go into far in. But this is a really cool place to put a lounge chair for the folks to just come and hang out a bit and to just watch the waves come up at the back of the property. So let's get an overall view of what we just built. You have your pool area. So let's build our hot tub. So we're going to do a pool here. And we're going to go one in from each side. And we're going to go four across. And three up. So do four and three up. So you've got four across and three up. That's going to be considered your hot tub. And you've got the walkway to walk around the property. So let's look at what we just built. Let's do our rooms. So we have at the very beginning, we've got a bedroom, master bedroom here. We've got the child's room. We've got the game room, the main bathroom for anyone to use. We've got the entryway. We've got the kitchen area, what we're going to be calling a hot tub for this presentation. And then we have our pool area back here. As you remember, I like to place my windows and doors in first, which gives me an idea of how I'm going to be decorating each and every room. So let's start with the main entrance. We're going to go into the door sections. Let's go. I have some doors in inventory, so we'll use what's available. We're going to do a nice door here. So as I mentioned, you will come in from the front and you'll walk around to the side and come in through the main area here. We're going to put a door here off of the main entrance for the bathroom door. So you can use the bathroom off the main entrance. We're going to put a small archway from the main entrance into the kitchen area. Actually, we can actually put a bigger archway. I think there's enough space to do a bigger archway. Let's see. Perfect. So you get a bigger archway off the main entrance into the kitchen area. For the living room area, we're not going to put any door here. We're going to put the barbecue grill here and the chairs for the patio furniture there. So to enter into the living room, we need to come in through the main area and go into the living room. So we're going to do an arch off the main area into the living room area. And from the living room area, you can get into the game room. You'll do another arch there. Let's try a small arch. Oh, let's do that one more time. Let's do the arch right there. So perfect. And to get into the child's room, since it's a toddler, we're going to do a big arch. Mom is not dating at the moment, so when mom decides to date, we will change this to a door. And change the entrance from mom's bedroom into the game room. That's for the future. And again, to mom's bedroom, we'll put a nice door at the front. Right there is perfect. We're going to put an archway here for this bathroom to the bedroom area. To enter into this bedroom, you're going to be able to come in through the living room area. So we'll do a door there. So you can enter into this bedroom from the living room area, into this bedroom from the pool area. Hate when that happens, the door changes, so we'll put that in for later. We will leave that for storage for now. Leave that there, and then we will put some shrubbery here so that the walkway doesn't try to come towards this back entrance. So those are all the doors I believe we need currently. Let's just double check. From the kitchen area, we can do a, let's do a small arch from the kitchen area straight into the pool area. For me, I'm going to do a lot of windows at this back area here from the living room so you can look out onto the pool area. So let's get some big windows. Or just do a few small windows all the way across. So you have a lot of sunlight. And we're going to do one archway from the living room area from the kitchen to the pool area. Need more than one way to get to the pool, so let's do that there. Beautiful. Let's see what we have now, so we can get in and out and around this entire space. And we can try doing the tiki bar area here. So we're going to go over into outdoor furniture. And we're going to look for a covered table, umbrella table. So we can put that here. And we can put some chairs around. Oh, I think I'm not in my inventory. Let's go back into the umbrella armchair, go into the inventory, and go into the pool area. I still have an outdoor furniture in my pool. Furniture. And I do have some chairs. I love the fact that they give you the numbers at the top so you know exactly what you have in your storage. So very cool. Let's use some chairs. This is just an idea. Of course, you can decorate it anyhow you see fit. And so that's just an idea there. And like I mentioned, you can place a lounge chair over here so you can watch the waves come in and out. Relax in the evening when you come from work, you just want to relax. Let's put another one there because you and your child might want to do that. Or maybe the tenants might want to just hang out there for a hot second. And what is so great about the decorative tiles, you can actually place something, a plant or a coconut tree. Let's see if the coconut tree works on it. So you get some shade. That is so very cool. So you got some shade happening. You can watch the waves coming in the evening. And we leave this area on this side for the tiki bar. So just an idea. Just ideas you can play around with it. But I'll leave all the decorating that you want to do, all the color scheme, the floors and the windows, I'll leave for that for you to do this time out, since you've rather advanced in decorating. So this is what it looks like. I think it's so very cool. So you've got the bathroom that connects to this bedroom over here. This person, of course, is going to pay more rent. You've got the master bedroom for the mom, a place for her toddler. You've got a game room, the guitar, foosball, painting, whatever works. You've got the bathroom here, a small bathroom, an entryway. You've got the main kitchen, which should be an eating kitchen. You've got the living room in the middle, which is central to the whole entire house. You've got the second bedroom, the patio furniture, what we're going to be calling a hot tub for our purposes. And we've got a rather large pool in the back. But of course, which I'm so happy to keep mentioning, the waves coming into the back wall. So that is what we're built today. We've built a family home for a widow, her child, and two tenants. As always, remember to save your latest version to the cloud first before you make any changes. Remember, everything you just saw will be detailed out below in the information section. Remember to subscribe to FX Avatar's channel. Thanks for viewing. Thanks for subscribing. Thanks for the comments. We love hearing from you. Happy simming. This is FX Avatar signing off. Till next time.